What would happen to Gotham City if Batman was believed to be dead? Would the criminals go crazy? Would there be a battle for the next Batman? Well, if you've been following our videos that follow the Batman storyline, then you know that Batman had a son named Damian Wayne, and while he initially tried to train him to be Robin, Talia ran off with Damian, and Batman didn't know where he ended up. Following that event, Batman eventually ended up investigating the death of the new god Orin, which led him to be supposedly killed in the Final Crisis storyline. Well, we know that Batman is lost in time thanks to the Batman in Time storyline, but the rest of Gotham wasn't aware of this. Batman's will stated that Dick Grayson should take over as Batman if anything should ever happen to him, but Dick Grayson doesn't think he can do it, and he's refusing to take up the Batman mantle. So what happened in Gotham while Batman was lost in time, and Dick Grayson refused to become Batman? Every Batman ally has been called in. Things are getting worse for Gotham by the day. All of Gotham has heard of Batman's death, and the crime organizations aren't afraid of Batman's allies. They can take those kids out. Nightwing has become cold and emotionless, and things are different with Bruce gone. Most of Batman's allies are here. Red Robin, Oracle, Huntress, Night, Squire, Catwoman, Damian, and they're all looking to Nightwing for guidance as they try to get the gangs of Gotham under control. But he doesn't see himself as the new Batman. He can barely hold himself together. Recently, Arkham was made unlivable by a toxic gas that was released there, and all of the inmates are being moved over to Blackgate, all on one bus. Whoever planned that out really wasn't thinking things too well, because Black Mask sees this as an opportunity, and he hijacks the bus, freeing every Batman villain and setting them loose on the city that is barely holding itself together with a string. He takes them all under his control, and it's time for the Batman Rogues Gallery to have their fun. There's no bat to stop them. There's no bat for them to fear. There's only a Gotham to fear the rogues of Batman. Back in the Batcave, Dick cannot bring himself to pull the Batman cape and cowl out. He just can't do it. He can't become Batman. Well, Tim gets into an argument with Dick. Gotham needs Batman. The criminals of Gotham need something to fear. And it looks like somebody else may have already taken up the mantle of Batman. A brutal, deadly Batman is roaming around the city of Gotham, killing off the gangs. Who is this guy? Nightwing and the police all sit down and they decide this is gonna be a crazy few nights with all the inmates of Arkham all going around free. And while they're talking about this, Damian is dealing with his father's death by joyriding in a stolen Batmobile, only to be sideswiped by Killer Croc. Oracle quickly dispatches Huntress and Black Hawk, but luckily Nightwing is already in the area nearby because Damian is about to fight both Killer Croc and Poison Ivy. But as Nightwing picks up Damian with the Bat Glider, they both get shot out of the sky. It's some of the random gangs of Gotham. Like I said, they're not afraid of anyone but Batman. But our new brutal gun-toting Batman jumps in to save Nightwing and Damian. He quickly makes short work of the gang and then rather rudely tells Nightwing, "This is how things are gonna need to be. Don't cling to the ways of your mentor. It's what got your mentor killed." And he says that he's gonna be here to kill the problems of Gotham. Then poof, this brutal Batman leaves. But Nightwing and Damian chase after him, and the three have a little fight of their own. But this new Batman keeps referring to Batman as Bruce, and he keeps referring to Nightwing as Dick Grayson. It doesn't take Nightwing long to figure it out. This brutal Batman is Jason Todd. But since Damian was injured in this fight, everyone stays to help him while Jason Todd gets away. The villains of Gotham are now loose and going crazy on Gotham without any real Batman to scare them. So all of the allies of Batman are now getting distracted, and this leaves Nightwing, Red Robin, and Damian alone to deal with this Jason Todd situation all by themselves. Alfred tries to convince Dick Grayson to once again become Batman. Who else can uphold the ideals of Bruce other than Dick? But while contemplating it again, Dick notices something. The Batsuit is missing. Tim Drake, aka Red Robin, has taken it and he's gone off hunting for Jason Todd himself. He'll stop this. No one will tarnish Bruce Wayne's legacy. With Tim as smart as he is, he quickly figures out where Jason Todd is hiding, and it turns out that Jason has his own brutal Batman cave. But before Tim can get the upper hand on Jason, Jason jumps on him and he beats the tar out of him. And their fight ends with an old rusty batarang being shoved into Tim's chest. That's just wrong, Jason! Nightwing gets on the road looking for Tim, and he eventually comes across the Batman cape and cowl being hung up and a recorded message from Jason Todd. Jason taunts Dick by claiming that Tim is dead and that Dick has failed everyone. And when Dick goes to remove the cape from the stand that it's on, Jason shocks him! And then Jason walks over to the knocked down Nightwing and he gives another speech, offering Nightwing to become his new Robin. Jason has snapped, he's just gone completely crazy, and Nightwing sees this as he gets a second wind and punches Jason Todd. But before Jason can recover, Nightwing goes ahead and throws a pre-recorded holographic message from Bruce to Jason. Bruce tells Jason that he's sorry, and that Jason Todd is his greatest failure. But it's not too late. Jason can still get help. This infuriates Jason, and Nightwing and him go to town, with Nightwing just demanding, "Where is Tim?" While this is going on, Tim wakes back up, and he begins to walk off to try and get some help. He was faking his death the whole time. Back with Dick and Jason, Jason blows up his brutal Batcave, forcing a cave-in. Everyone begins to fall down this falling in, caved-in Batcave, and the barely conscious Tim goes with it, and Damian Wayne then shows up to save Tim from certain death. Dick and Jason end up jumping to a nearby speeding train to continue their battle of who will be Batman on top of a speeding train. Well, after a few more awesome martial arts moves, Nightwing finishes off Jason Todd finally, knocking him away and down into the river below. After all of this, Dick Grayson knows there needs to be a Batman. And if it's one thing Jason did correctly, it was put the fear of Batman back into Gotham, and he needs to be there. So from this day forward, Dick Grayson is Batman, and Damian is his Robin. Well, he's Batman until Batman comes back. But, as with most of our stories go, the return of Bruce Wayne is a story for another day. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you guys next time right here at Comicstorian.